Welcome back to Schweitzer Kids Online. Here's today's agenda. You can skip ahead or double back to catch the content you like best. Today's memory verse is James 1:5.
If you need wisdom, ask our generous God and he will give it to you. James 1:5.
We'll talk more about wisdom later on, but for now, let's get warmed up with a song. This is Schweitzer Kids bringing you the good news. Wow, that song never gets old. Such a great message that we all have what it takes to be a hero. This week, we're going to talk about wisdom. And wisdom is knowing the difference between right and wrong according to God. And it's not just about being smart. It's really...
Did someone say smart?
Well, yes, but actually, that's...
Our friend Taylor hasn't given up on his quest to become the world's first real-life superhero. Today, he's dressed as Brainy Boy, the world's smartest superhero. Let's hear more about his powers.
I'm Brainy Boy, the world's smartest superhero.
Wow, your head is huge.
Of course it is. It has to contain my comically large brain.
Well, you must be really smart.
I am very smart. Ask me any math question.
What's 3 minus 4?
-1, easy.
Okay, how about 6 times a billion?
6 billion, give me something hard.
All right, okay. 54 is 45 less than what number?
8?
No, sorry, it's 9.
Yeah, I know it's 9, I was testing you. obviously.
Okay. Well, how about this? What other ways are you smart?
Okay, you got me. I'm a fraud. I'm not smart. This is a fake brain. Oh man.
Taylor, fake brain. Oh, yeah, that's not good.
I was never even smart in school. I'm a fraud.
Well, Taylor, that's okay, because like I was saying, we're talking about wisdom today. It's different from that kind of smart.
What is wisdom?
Well, like I was saying before, wisdom is knowing what is right and what is wrong according to God. It's not just being smart, it's about judgment.
How am I supposed to know the difference between right and wrong?
Well, the Holy Spirit will help you. And today we're going to talk about a Bible story where we see the Holy Spirit being sent to the apostles for the very first time. Jesus had told the disciples that one day the Holy Spirit would come to them and help them to teach others about him. And one day, after Jesus rose from the dead, and after he had already gone back to heaven, the disciples and other Christians were having a meal together and thanking God, when suddenly a sound like the blowing of a strong wind came from heaven. Next, they saw tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. When the tongues of fire came, they were filled with the Holy Spirit and began speaking in different languages. And then they ran out into the streets to tell people about what had happened. They all got pretty excited and things got a bit noisy. People from many different countries were staying in Jerusalem at the time and were surprised to hear their own languages being spoken. Things must have sounded crazy.
I feel like some people probably would have made fun of them.
Well, yeah, some of the crowd did start making fun of them and started to think that they had too much wine and it was making them act funny. When Peter started to hear these rumors, he raised his voice and talked to the crowd. He explained that they weren't drinking wine because it was only 9 in the morning, and they preferred coffee that early in the morning anyway, I'm sure. He explained that Jesus had told them this would happen. Peter told them all about Jesus and how he had died for them and rose again. He explained that they should repent, say they're sorry, basically, and stop doing those bad things they were doing, and be baptized so that the others would know that they believed in God and were trying to change. Because of Jesus' death and his resurrection, people could be forgiven and receive the Holy Spirit from now on. As the disciples went about their lives, the Holy Spirit gave them the wisdom to always know what is right and what is wrong.
I want to grow and learn. How do I become more wise? How do I do it?
Well, that's great, Taylor. All you have to do is remember today's Bible verse. It tells you everything you need to know.
If you need wisdom, ask our generous God and he will give it to you. James 1:5.
That's all I have to do?
That's right. Just read your Bible and pray to God, and he'll give you the wisdom you need.
Wow. So God gives me power, courage, and wisdom. I know just what I need now to become the first real-life superhero.
Oh, boy. I wonder what Taylor's going to do next week. To check this story out on your own, grab your Bible and open to Acts 2.
Jesus, you have been so faithful. Jesus, you have been so true. I will be forever thankful, 'cause I never had a friend like you. Help me to be who you've been to me, to everyone I see. Let us love one another. You with me in the darkest valley, you with me on the mountaintop. I'm thankful that you never leave me, and that your love will never stop. Help me to be who you've been to me, to everyone I see. Let us love one another. I wanna see.
thank you for being a friend who's always by my side. I wanna thank you for the way you love me all my life. I wanna thank you for being a friend who's always by my side. I wanna thank you for the way you love me all my life. Love one another with that love like no other yet. That's the way you love us, God. Never turn away, you are with us every day, yeah.
All right, well, thanks for hanging with us this week. And as you go about your week, remember,
if you need wisdom, ask our generous God, and he will give it to you. James 1:5.
I'll see you next week for another message of truth to guide your life. And if you want some fun activities to do with your family and friends to tell us a little bit about God's plan for us, you can look on our webpage at sumc.co/kids. And remember, Jesus loves you, and so do we.
My God is strong. He'll do anything, big or small. Nothing is impossible for a super wonderful God. Every day I can know God is always there for me and my family. Every day I can know greater is the one who lives inside me. Super.